As the heads of state and football federations of Tanzania, Kenya and Uganda continue to celebrate the victory of winning the bid to host the East Africa Pomoja AFCON 2027, some opposition politicians have openly expressed their fears that this opportunity might be misused. The recent reaction was from the Kampala Lord Mayor Erias Lukwago, who expressed fear that this blessing might be misused for corruption and clamping on people's human rights.
AFCON should not be used as an excuse to clamp down on civil liberties, on exercise of our right to assemble, on exercise of our right to freely express ourselves and to participate in the governance of this country. Two, it shouldn't be used as the cash bonanza for particular individuals. Those who are celebrating, yo, whoa, whoa, whoa. For them, it's all about feathering their nests. It's all about crude or barbaric ways of enriching themselves.
However, the Minister of Information, Dr. Chris Waryomunsi, has said that such negativity is uncalled for.
Can we manage, can we handle? The answer is yes. The answer is yes. And for Mr. Maviris to write saying they cancel the bid, no, they are idolers who just want to give themselves work.
He asked Ugandans to focus on the opportunities that come with hosting AFCON.
If you are a patriotic Ugandan, you should be proud that Uganda, together with Tanzania and Kenya, have won the bid to host AFCON 2027. It is something very positive. It is something all of us should be proud of. But I think some Ugandans are wired differently. They hate Uganda as if they have another home, another country.
On the other development, Waryomunsi trashed allegations that the government plans to switch off the internet anytime because NUPS party president Bobi Wine is going to be coming back to the country from Canada.
Rumors that the government intended to switch off internet. So you wanted the Minister of Information for the government of Uganda to address you on rumors. First of all, I'm not even aware that Bobi Wine is returning. Where is he? I thought he's in the country. He's outside the country. Yeah? He's coming back from where? Yeah? On Thursday, where is he coming from?
Canada.
From Canada to Uganda?
Yes.
As government, we are not even bothered. He can come either in a parachute or in a helicopter or in what? He's a Ugandan, like all of us. He's not a bad or stopped from coming to Uganda. He should return like any other person returns to Uganda. So your fears of shutting internet, why? What is the connection between shutting down internet and his return?
Report compiled by Juliet Namoya for the news.